thousands and thousands of people who have been touched by the Krishna consciousness movement, primarily through the individual entreaties of devotees who have gone out of their way to meet people where they live, in public, speaking, distributing literature, giving prasadam, extending their hearts to people, have come from a position of complete darkness, meaning they don't believe there is another life, they don't believe spiritual life is important, and so forth, to fully embracing the process of Krishna consciousness and wondering, what was I thinking before? So it's altogether necessary, and it's also the mandate of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to go everywhere. He did it himself. He traveled to many parts of India, and in cases where he met people who were from various other cultures, he gave them the same message. Of course, in a palatable way. We speak to people in their own language so that they can appreciate it. That's called realization. But he did go everywhere in Prabhupada notes, even when he spoke to the Muslims and converted some of them to Krishna consciousness, specifically related to them through their own scriptures and culture and so forth. And Prabhupada says this is the duty of everyone as a follower of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to go to all parts of the world and meet people to give them the opportunity to take to Krishna consciousness. And the Srimad Bhagavatam, Shukadeva Goswami says, in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Shukadeva Goswami says, Kirata hunandra pulinda pulkasha abhira shumba yavan. Yavana kasadaya, yene cha papa, yadapashaya shaya shudyanti tasmai. Pravavishnave namaha. That Krishna is so powerful that through his devotees, he can elevate anyone from any situation in life. And he names many different categories of people who have become estranged from the culture of God consciousness. So today we're going to have a time to discuss our realizations, talk about our realizations from the past year in the propagation of Krishna consciousness, in the cultivation of our own Krishna consciousness. We're going to take at least a couple hours. And we're going to then take prasadam. Then we're going to have a brainstorming session for another couple of hours to talk about how to do it better the next year. And that's one of the means by which we advance in Krishna consciousness is by looking each year to improve what we've done previously. Each month, what we've done previously. And when the tension is there, when there's a goal to be met, then we have some impetus to improve. In the last days of our marathon, Malini and a couple of devotees came to me. They were wondering whether to go to Fremont or to downtown San Francisco. And I said, oh, go down to San Francisco, have fun. And they came back the next week and said, it wasn't that much fun because we didn't have the same pressure. We didn't have the goal hanging over our head to do a certain thing. It wasn't fun. We can't have, there is just no fun in this world except for working hard for Krishna with a sense of responsibility. And interestingly enough, even in that feeling of anxiety for getting our service done, we're actually experiencing some bliss. That tapasya, there's a little heat. Whereas left without any direction or any goal, we may be lackadaisical, we may not consider making improvements. We also may become dissuaded even from doing our service and do something else instead. And that's not fun, that's actually the greatest suffering, to be disconnected from one's intense service. Service is intense. Mother Yashoda is 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Not that there's any time in the spiritual world, the consideration is there that she never stops thinking about Krishna and how to protect him from monkeys, from fire, from all kinds of demons. Everyone's always thinking Krishna, worrying about him in a complete anxiety. And in that anxiety, there's bliss. It's complete bliss. And also in the separation from Krishna, there's the highest sense of bliss. And we should also feel that in our service, that if we, even the prospect of being separated from our service for a moment should make us feel great anxiety. So let's recite a few important verses from the Srimad Bhagavatam before we start. Can we have full screen view, please? Is it possible? Or do we have to have all that on the left? Okay. Let's recite together. Kvachinivartate padrat kvachid charati tat punaha prayaschitam ato partam manye kunjara shauchavat. Translation. Sometimes one who is very alert so as not to commit sinful acts is victimized by sinful life again. I therefore consider this process of repeated sinning and atoning to be useless. It is like the bathing of an elephant, for an elephant cleanses itself by taking a full bath, but then throws dust over its head and body as soon as it returns to the land. This is from the from Srila Prabhupada's Shloka book. The sixth canto important verses that Prabhupada used frequently for those of you online who would like to refer to your books if you need to. And also we welcome you, everyone who's joined us on the internet. Thank you very much for joining the universal community of hearing and chanting. Next, please. Tapasya brahmacharyena shamina cha dhamina cha Tyagina satya shaucha bhyam yamina niyamina va. To concentrate the mind, one must observe a life of celibacy and not fall down. One must undergo the austerity of voluntarily giving up sense enjoyment. One must then control the mind and senses, give charity, be truthful, clean, and nonviolent. Follow the regulative principles and regularly chant the holy name of the Lord. Kechit kevalaya bhaktya vasudeva parayanaha agham dundvandi kartsnyena niharam iva bhaskaraha. Only a rare person who has adopted complete unalloyed devotional service to Krishna can uproot the weeds of sinful action with no possibility that they will revive. He can do this simply by discharging devotional service, just as the sun can immediately dissipate fog by its rays. Yamaduta uchuhu veda pranihito dharmo yadharmas tad viparyayaha vedo narayana sakshad swayambur iti shushruma. The Yamadutas reply, that which is prescribed in the Vedas constitutes dharma, the religious principles, and the opposite of that is irreligion. The Vedas are directly the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Narayan, and are self-born. This we have heard from Yamaraj. Dharmam tu sakshat bhagavat pranitam navai vidur rishayo napi devaha Nasiddha mukya asura manushya kuto nu vidyadara charanadayaha. Real religious principles are enacted by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Although fully situated in the mode of goodness, even the great rishis who occupy the topmost planets cannot ascertain the real religious principles, nor can the demigods or the leaders of Siddhaloka, to say nothing of the asuras, ordinary human beings, vidyadharas, and charanas. Swayambhur narada shambhu kumara kapilo manuhu pralado janako bhishmo balirvaya sakirvayam. Lord Brahma, Bhagavan Narada, Lord Shiva, the four Kumaras, Lord Kapila, the son of Devahuti, Swayambhuva Manu, Prahlad Maharaj, Janak Maharaj, Grandfather Bhishma, Bali Maharaj, Shukadev Goswami, and I myself know the real religious principle. Etavan eva loke smin pum sam dharma parasmritaha bhakti yogo bhagavati tanama grahanadibhi. Devotional service, beginning with the chanting of the holy name of the Lord, is the ultimate religious principle for the living entity in human society. Tasmat sankirtanam vishnor jagan mangalam anghasam mahatam api kauravya vidyaikantika nishkritam. My dear king, the chanting of the holy name of the Lord is able to uproot even the reactions of the greatest sins. Therefore, the chanting of the Sankirtan movement is the most auspicious activity in the universe. Please try to understand this so that others will take it seriously. Muktanam api siddhanam narayana parayanaha sudurlabha prashantatma kutishwapi mahamune. O great sage, among many millions who are liberated and perfect in knowledge of liberation, one may be a devotee of Lord Narayan or Krishna. Such devotees who are fully peaceful are extremely rare. Narayana paraksarvena kutaschana pibhyati swarga pavarga narakeshu apitulyarta darshinaha. Devotees solely engaged in the devotional service of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Narayana, never fear any condition of life. For them, the heavenly planets, liberation, and the hellish planets are all the same. For such devotees are interested only in the service of the Lord. Kama dveshad bhayad snehad yata bhakteshvare manaha avesha tat agam hitva bahavas tat gatim gataha. Many, many persons have attained liberation simply by thinking of Krishna with great attention and giving up sinful activities. This great attention may be due to lusty desires, inimical feelings, fear, affection, or devotional service. Gopya kamad bayat kamso dveshach chaityadayo nripaha sambandad vrishnaya snehad yuyam bhakta vayam vibho. My dear King Yudhishthira, the gopis by their lusty desires, Kamsa by his fear, Shishupal and other kings by envy, the Yadus by their familial relationship with Krishna, you Pandavas by your great affection for Krishna, and we the general devotees by our devotional service have obtained the mercy of Krishna. Katamo pina vina syat panchamam purusham prati tasmat kenyap yupayena mana krishne niveshayet. Somehow or other, one must consider the form of Krishna very seriously. Then, by one of the five different processes mentioned above, one can return home back to Godhead. Atheists like King Vena, however, being unable to think of Krishna's form in any of these five ways, cannot attain salvation. Therefore, one must somehow think of Krishna, whether in a friendly way or inimically. Shriparlaru vacha tatsaru manye suravarya dehinam sadasamudvigna dhyam sadgrahat hivabhapatam griyamandakupam vanavgrato yadharim ashrayeta. This is the bonus one because it went into the seventh canto. So you get a bonus verse this morning. Prahlad Maharaj replied, "O best of the Asuras, king of the demons, as far as I have learned from my spiritual master, any person who has accepted a temporary body and temporary household life is certainly embarrassed by anxiety because of having fallen in a dark well where there is no water but only suffering. One should give up this position and go to the forest, Vana. One should go to Vrindavana, where only Krishna consciousness is prevalent, and one should thus take shelter of the Supreme Personality of Godhead." Srimad Bhagavatam Ki Jai. Did you like those verses?
Yes.
Do you feel better now? It's the cure to all anxieties and mental speculations is to take shelter of the Bhagavatam in a systematic way. It has to be systematic because the mind will attack us from various angles and tell us that we have other better things to do. But make no mistake about it, there is no better activity than hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. In fact, one of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's associates was given the service that 24 hours a day he'd simply read Bhagavatam to Mahaprabhu. He would sing it in various tunes. And this is an occupation in and of itself. Not many people get that occupation. Not many people have the opportunity. Several times devotees have come to me and said, "I'm thinking about getting a PhD in such and such a thing." And he said, "Why don't you just get a PhD in the Srimad Bhagavatam? Because who has one?" And those who do have those PhD in the Srimad Bhagavatam, they become very valuable in society. Someone takes the trouble to get a PhD in the Bhagavad Gita. Everyone says, "Oh, I know Bhagavad Gita." No, you don't. Just by saying that means you don't know Bhagavad Gita. Get a PhD in Bhagavad Gita, write a dissertation on Bhagavad Gita, and then teach it to others. That's life. That's sankirtan. Hear and chant and go give it to as many other people as possible. That's the real occupation. That occupation is backed by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and you can't beat that. Anywhere in the three worlds, you won't get a better job placement than that. That's secure also because as Narada Muni, he has unlimited engagement. You see him coming out everywhere in the Shastra. He just shows up to do his service in the most amazing places. So this is what we've been given. This is our sankirtan. We've been given this opportunity to go anywhere we like, and nobody can stop us. We can go behind enemy lines. We'll figure out ways to inject the Bhagavat Katha into human society one way or another. It's not part of the discussion now. Everyone's talking about anxiety-ridden topics. How to protect the material body. That's not possible. Therefore, everyone's in anxiety. And everyone's separating God from their lives in all kinds of variety, various ways, unlimited ways. There are 8,400,000 species of life. Opportunities to forget God, most of them. To fly in the air. I was watching birds yesterday fly in the tree. They're so adroit, and they can move freely from one branch to another, from one house to another, over neighborhoods. And they're arrogantly forgetting God in that species of life because it's the rebellious nature of the living entity. So now we're making a declaration. We're turning back towards Krishna. Willfully, we've decided this is the highest occupation in life, is to hear and chant about Krishna and to remember him in all circumstances. It doesn't matter where we are, what situation of life we're in, what happens to the material body, there is no impediment to devotional service. So we'll try to squeeze out every bit of Krishna Katha we can within the short amount of time we have left in this lifetime, in every day, in every month, in every year. And that's why we're gathered here today. It's not just about sankirtan goals, but it's about a lifetime of dedication to the process of hearing and chanting and helping each other come up to the stage of purity because it's our only force. Our team is held together. We're all volunteers. And everyone needs this purity of heart in order to go on with their service. If they lose it, if they get into association that's discouraging or that's distracting, they'll also become affected. We have to appreciate everyone and fan the spark within the heart of everybody that is around us, because a chain's only as strong as its weakest link. And our team is held together here by the purity of intention. And that can only come from chanting good rounds. If you don't chant good 16 rounds, which is the prescription given by our founder Acharya, very difficult to think straight. You may concoct many different things, but they won't be accurate in the long run. And we must also read all of Prabhupada's books. If you make your occupation systematically going through every single one of Srila Prabhupada's books and making sure that you read it from cover to cover, every page, every preface, every table of contents, you'll be occupied from now until the time you take your last breath. And when you do take your last breath, you'll be thinking of Krishna, because that's why he provided those books. And he said, everything I had to say, I said in my books. And I read last night when I was doing some research that he was saying, I can't possibly talk to everybody. Now after he had a certain number of disciples, after about 1968, 69, when so many disciples started coming in, Prabhupada got overwhelmed with letters. He started thinking of ways he would answer the letters while he was taking massage. Someone else would type them out. He'd read the letter, type them out, and then he'd start saying, you answer the letter to his head disciples and so forth. And then later on he told, it's mathematically impossible to answer everyone. He said, that's why I'm putting everything in my books. And if you simply read my books carefully, you'll know what I had to say, and you'll know what's in my heart. That's what we've got, and we're lucky to have it. We're lucky to have the impetus to want to have it, and we're trying to give it to other people as much as possible, as much as they can take it. And for that, we have to depend on Krishna in their hearts. Ishvara sarva bhutanam hride shera juna tishtiti Brahmayan sarvabhutani yantra rudrani mayaya. Krishna's there directing the living entity within the heart. And if he gets a little contact with devotional service, Krishna will inform him, this is a good idea, you should take this up. It's up to the soul to take it or not take it, but Krishna will help from within the heart. So today we're going to hear the realizations of the devotees, if I ever stop talking. From what's happened this year, last year, 2014, it was our best year ever in Sankirtan. I also noticed that Los Angeles may have had its biggest year in history. They gave over $300,000 to the BBT, $336,000. Other notable temples in the top three in America were the Rupanuga Vedic College traveling party, and coming in number three was ISKCON of Silicon Valley. By a lot. That means everyone else, number four and everyone after that is quite a bit further behind ISKCON of Silicon Valley, and we're just a little temple. We just have a few volunteers here. I hope we're held together with rubber bands and string, but but our determination is to get better every year, to somehow or other please Srila Prabhupada, and it's difficult. It's difficult to hold people together these days, to keep everything going in one direction, to manage a household. To manage an apartment is difficult. Manage a hut is difficult in this day. What's the speak of an apartment? You got to have renter's insurance and all kinds of other junk. But to speak of a house, it's like running a major business. But to speak of a temple, that's a big, what is it? It's a scale of a company. Like, it is running a company. It's a non-profit company. And we're doing it for a reason. We're doing it so that we can create this space so that everyone can come in. All living entities are welcome to be born here if they like. Please, I'm announcing. Any demigods up there who are cashing in their Sukriti so they can be born in Kali Yuga, you can be born here. Just come help us in the Sankirtan movement. Other living entities anywhere in the universe, come here. We will do the best we can to create an environment so you can hear and chant about Krishna, talk about Krishna, chant Hare Krishna, which is the essence of all the Vedas, and we'll take you back home, back to Godhead by itself. And we'll do our best to follow the order of our founder, Acharya, which is to follow four regulative principles strictly, to chant 16 rounds, and then to do our best to spread the Sankirtan movement, and racking our brains in any way that we can to make sure that it gets out to as many people as possible. And so please feel free, take birth here at ISKCON Silicon Valley. There's plenty of opportunity. For living entities to appear here. So we're inviting you, and anybody else already born wants to come here or participate and help from afar where there's no more geographical boundaries. We are Bhaktas Without Borders is our program. Bhaktas Without Borders. Okay, so today we're going to hear from devotees their realizations of 2014. Some of the devotees are prepared, others they'll be a little more spontaneous, but as things going, we'll keep it short, and then if we need repeats and you want to say more later, we can. Do you want to set up a chair here, or do you want to pass around the microphone, or what do you want to do? Pass the mic around? Okay. So hearing the realizations of other devotees is guhyam akyachi prichiti. We hear what's in the heart of devotees, what realization Krishna has given them from their activities in Krishna consciousness. And it'll be nice today and any day, but we'd like to capture as many of the strong points as possible, usable points. I see Shraddha has her laptop open, as usual, ready to take down information. So either one of the co-Sankirtan leaders want to say anything as a preamble?
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Prabhuji, I was actually reflecting for past whole week about the marathon, the Sankirtan for the whole year. And one theme kept repeating all the time is that devotees actually were working together this year with full dedication and devotion. Previously, we used to have MSF weekends, like there used to be a set weekend in a month that this month devotees would go out on book distribution. But this year, when I was putting down the MSF dates, I realized that we don't do that anymore because we go out every weekend now. So there is no specific MSF weekend that we go out on book distribution. So I'm actually grateful to all the devotees who are going out every weekend these days on book distribution.
This is the positive side of mission creep. This is the kind of mission creep we like. Very nice. Beautiful. Thank you.
There are so many more, but I would... If time permits, then I can say more. But there is one verse that I thought that it was. I was reading yesterday night from Srimad Bhagavatam, and then this was about Narada Muni. He was explaining how he saw Krishna, and the moment he saw Krishna, then immediately Krishna disappeared, and with mechanical ways, he was trying to bring that image back in his mind, but then a voice came, Krishna revealed from his, as a voice, and he said that you cannot just see me just by your endeavors, you have to be freed from all material desires. In that purport, actually, Srila Prabhupada was mentioning that that actually seeing Krishna means actually doing service. And that's a very, very nice purport, I felt like. That's 1623 from Srimad Bhagavatam. Prabhu, should we read?
Would you like to? Yeah, please.
The translation says, "O virtuous one, you may have only seen my person, and this is just to increase your desire for me." 1622, sorry Prabhu. O virtuous one, you have only seen my person, and this is just to increase your desire for me, because the more you hanker for me, the more you'll be freed from all material desires. Purport by Srila Prabhupada. A living being cannot be vacant of desires. He is not a dead stone. He must be working, thinking, feeling, and willing. But when he thinks, feels, and wills materially, he becomes entangled. And conversely, when he thinks, feels, and wills for the service of the Lord, he becomes gradually freed from all entanglement. The more a person is engaged in transcendental loving service of the Lord, the more he acquires a hankering for it. That is the transcendental nature of godly service. Material service has satiation, whereas spiritual service of the Lord has neither satiation nor end. One can go on increasing his hankerings for the loving transcendental service of the Lord, and yet he will not find satiation or end. By intense service of the Lord, one can experience the presence of the Lord transcendentally. Therefore, seeing the Lord means being engaged in his service, because his service and his person are identical. The sincere devotee should go on with sincere service of the Lord. The Lord will give proper direction as to how and where it has to be done. There was no material desire in Narada, and yet just to increase his intense desire of the Lord, he was so advised. So Prabhuji, I was just thinking that the devotees here are going on and on and on without stopping. And even though they're doing so much of service, practically going out every weekend, they are still not satiated. Last 2 weekends of the December, we didn't go for book distribution, and everybody was hankering that when is our next Sankirtan. So I just was thinking that how the level of the devotees has increased so much for the past year.
Beautiful. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna. We're taking realizations from your experiences in Sankirtan.
Hare Krishna. I was thinking, like Srila Prabhupada tells in Bhagavad Gita, like devotional service means, bhakti means devotional service, and devotional service means service to the devotees and the service to the Krishna consciousness activities. So, when we go out on Sankirtan, Prabhu, we meet different devotees and many people. One Mataji asked me recently that you are covering entire Bay Area like every year, like Fremont, Cupertino, and many areas. You are not exhausted. And I was meditating on this particular point, Prabhu, but by Krishna's mercy, we are never exhausted, Prabhu. Wherever we go, we meet like you choose one spot, and it's by Prabhupada's mercy or Krishna's or devotee's mercy, we meet again new people. Every time it's new people, and I mean, some people maybe never got know Hare Krishna also. Like I met one lady last night, she's from Fiji, Prabhu. And she said, you're putting this tilak and what is your practice? You went to for church and many questions. But I understood, like if you won't go out and give these books to the people or people in general, so how we can get taste within ourselves, like meeting people, giving Krishna consciousness, that is the highest thing. So by like Bay Area is not exhausted, Prabhu. We are not done any, even not even a scratch. So I pray all devotees who came for entire marathon, they never said no. Whenever we call them, they came for Sankirtan and leaving everything out. And because of all devotees only, we are able to reach this goal. And I'm thanking each and every devotee for contributed for this marathon. Thank you.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Hare Vamsha One.
Hare please forgive if I am a little incoherent. I didn't prepare. I was just thinking in the morning, which of the few points or few bullets that I would like to take with me from 2014 MSFs. So I could think of these four things: books, goals, anxiety, and cooperation. And if we rewind back, I mean, that has been the main pillars, even all the way up till the time of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and all our acharyas. At the time when Goswamis were living in Vrindavan, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told them to write books, and he gave them concrete goals that you have to do this, and he gave instructions: excavate these temples, take out bhakti as the main process of all the Vedic literatures. And it was not that their journey was easy. We see so many examples of anxiety, like Rupa Goswami. He couldn't find Govindadev temple and he was distraught. So there were anxiety in their lives also. But they mitigated all this by very sincere cooperation for the mission of the of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Then we even fast forward it a little more. Narottam Das Thakur, Srinivas Acharya, Ramchandra Kaviraj, Shamanand Prabhu, Rasikanand Prabhu, all of them were given goals as well. And Srinivas Acharya especially was deputed to take charge of this mission of taking the books of the Goswamis by Jiva Goswami to Gauda Desh. Books and goals. And goals was specifically distribute these books, and Shamanand Prabhu and others were told to go in Utkala Desh and preach specific goals. But then again, their path was not easy. There was so much anxiety, the whole set of books get lost. I mean, it's unimaginable, because these days if books get lost, maybe we can print it. There are ways to get around that. But that time they were writing on birch leaves, and first they had to dry, so many things. A lot of anxiety. But how did they mitigate this? Again, by cooperation. And Bhakti Ratnakar, I was reading, it explains so nicely that when the books, they found the books and got the books to their destination, how all of them rejoiced, just like we rejoice at every MSF offering once we hit the goals. And then we even fast forward it, and we see at the times of Srila Prabhupada, a traveling Sankirtan party, and then even library party at that time, how they had specific goals and books were the basis, and they were all cooperating, and there was also anxiety. I mean, sometimes they had to take permits, and we had deprogrammers. So a lot of anxiety at that time also. So when I look back, 2014 and the MSFs, and these four pillars ring, the books, goals, anxiety, and cooperation, I think that basically we are reliving 15th century. We are reliving what Goswamis were doing in Vrindavan, what Narottam Das Thakur and other associates were doing in Gaur Desh, what Srila Prabhupada and his parshas, his associates were doing the whole world. We are doing that same in ISKCON Silicon Valley. So it's a very, very pushing experience, and only calls to that we push more. So I'm very thankful that I'm a little part of that and got the opportunity to be a part. And looking forward to the coming 2 hours where we chalk out both goals and anxiety for 2015. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Sadhu, sadhu. More. Yes, Shraddha.
Hare Krishna. When we started planning last year, and when you were presenting at the temple president's meeting in January, you had brought up the topic of always sell in bunches. And that was a thing that was the common theme throughout the year. And I was a little bit nervous and about whether how will we able to, you know, sell them in bunches. so tuned to, like, you know, distributing one Bhagavad Gita or one Krishna book at a time. But then it is true, we were able to distribute so many Bhagavatams, so many Chaitanya Charitamritas. And I just work with Mukharvinda, distributing majorly at the corporations. And I would like to take this opportunity to actually to thank Mukharvinda, because he does a lot of the work that I cannot do because of my hands. So there's a lot of cooperation that happens in this little team. And this year particularly, Mukharvinda was just taking on book distribution in the last few years, but this year I could see the excitement, you know, start much earlier, and he was actually planning out things and strategizing, and, you know. At one point in time, we were looking at, you know, how do we raise the money? Let's go and go to many people. And then he said, no, let's distribute sets. And that strategy worked, you know, again, taking it back to distribute in bunches. One thing which I also noticed distributing books in the corporations is that there's a lot that is involved. We went door to door, and so I can do the contrast there, is that when you go door to door, there's a little bit of anonymity there, and you know, you can get away with certain things. But when you're in a corporation, you are there for your life, and people know your past, present, and they can govern your future. So we have to be, you know, we have to be very, 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 very careful, you know, when playing things in the corporation, you know, act very professionally about that, because we are representing an organization, and so they should not, you know, because we are like the ambassadors of ISKCON sitting in our organization, so they will form an opinion this way or that. One thing good that I noticed this year was that a lot of them did come to the temple to attend, so that was a good thing that we saw. I also noticed that people, some of them really are really big donors, but I've noticed that the big donors shy of donating every year. Like a two-year cycle is much better for them. So I was worried when a lot of the big donors kept on saying no or had started coming with some excuse, I've already donated to India and things like that. But then Krishna started sending, you know, new big donors. So Krishna's always there. At one point in time, I was very sick during the entire marathon with, you know, frozen shoulder and, you know, all kinds of virus and all those kind of things. And in December, I was completely surrendered to Krishna. I was like, Krishna, I can't do it physically. I just cannot do it. And then again, the mandals came to rescue because of Harivansha Prabhu's brainchild, the Goswami package that brought in, you know, a lot of people. And I was thinking about the Goswami package, considering the contents inside it, that people have already read the Nectar of Devotion. We have already given them Nectar of Instruction. You know, how do I present it? And then, you know, the funny thing is that the dhuli was a big, big attraction. People just, you know, they just went for it. I mean, even they don't read the book, they went. They were willing to pay $350 for Rupa Goswami's dhuli there. So, so I just came to the conclusion that, you know, just have faith in Krishna and anything else, in bunches or not.
Sugiwa means who's next? Japanese. Yes. Yes, I'd wait.
Hare Krishna. I think our goals in MSF are too easy. Every time in MSF we smash it. We need to challenge ourselves to do more books by making our goal harder. If we do rounds, and we need to do rounds before we go to book distribution, because if we tell people to do rounds, if we tell people to chant, there's no use if we don't chant ourselves. Hare Krishna, thank you.
So the kids will have 40% of the
one
goal.
Prabhuji, one more.
Yes.
We only go to apartments majority Indian sometimes. This knowledge should be passed on to Chinese, Japanese, Vietnamese, etc. They know very less and maybe none about Krishna. We should deliver Krishna to all. Kids' team should go to majority Chinese maybe one day. We should go where there's all kinds of people.
Hear, hear. Good work, Advait. Very good. Very good. I see a succession plan coming up. Who's next?
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So I just like to also thank you, Vaisesika Prabhu, for giving your continuous inspirations in the monthly Sankirtan festival and the book distribution process as well as the new methodology all the time. So I just wanted to bring some other dimensions of the book distribution where, as per the scriptures, how it really manifests. Just like, okama sarva kama vi moksha kama udaradi tibrena bhakti yogena yajati purusham param. So whatever the desires you have, either event up to liberation city is also fulfilled by the Lord if you worship. So I know when kids all go for book distribution, 6, 7, 8, sometimes the kids comes and after 1 hour they'll be tired or they want water. Then we may not have water bottle, but when you knock the door, immediately somebody will invite us. Oh, do you want to drink water? So it gives us, oh my goodness, Krishna is like arranging everything. Then I know sometimes kids come or they feel like hungry and Manjula Kanta Mataji is our, she brings cake and other things. So but that time if it's not available, then some doors open. Oh, do you like banana? Do you like take orange for the, they see the kids. So I compare with the scriptures is never failing in the things. Only thing is we do not realize that how Krishna is so subtly arranging the divine arrangement, because we are, the kids are really sincerely, you know, engaging in the book distribution. It's very, very authentic. Otherwise, all the Mataji, like Kameshwari Mataji, Manjula Kanta, Sukheshwari, Ananda, and many other, those who come for the book distribution, they bring something, the, you know, snacks, so that the kids are motivated well. So they have break time, which is 10 minutes, 2 hours, in every 2 hours. So that gives them more energy, they eat, they talk, and they make more strategy at the time, which directions they would go, which direction somebody else will go, and how to approach. And it becomes more competitive, but in a healthy mood. So that's very nice, one aspect I see. And the other part which I wanted to say, yesterday we are reading Prabhupada's pastimes, Lilamrut, from his childhood to up to at the age of his marriage. So I was going through the how each incident of Prabhupada is really relating to even book distribution. Just like the first incident which Prabhupada's pastimes is with you know, the chicken feeding, chicken soup, and how Prabhupada even at the age of very, I don't know, it's 1 year or sometimes very early age, 6 months or 1 year, how Prabhupada rejected by pushing this one out. So it did not even touch this one. So similarly, we have very, very strong impediments in the earlier stage where many things are coming, but as long as we are really remembering or touching to Krishna, those things have been taken away, because we have attachment. Many people I know, they say they have attachment to so many magazines, so many like Times, you can talk about different varieties of Illustrated Weekly or n number of things, but as long as it is bringing Krishna, so it is going away. Then when Prabhupada also grows old from 6 months, then he was giving an incident that in Calcutta at the age of 13, there was a communal riots where Prabhupada was just playing outside and immediately somebody says that there is a riots going on. And he said that a man with his knife is chasing to Prabhupada and how he was running. And later on Prabhupada realized it was just he remembered his DD Radha Govind. And that's why he is really saving Prabhupada even before, you know, at the age of 13. So we can also see many of the, not only in ISB, there are many devotees who have, I have seen in Facebook, put like in Ukraine and in some part of the Eastern Europe, how they have been really giving so much of realization how Krishna is saving them during book distribution in a greatest danger. Means Krishna is not saying in a word, rather than he is really doing it. So at least for ISB, we are not in such kind of grave situation that somebody is doing something aggressively, but we are always protected by Lord Nrsingadev, always. And the third one, which I wanted to say, before the monthly Sankirtan festival, I can just bring some of the, like 9 years ago, maybe 10 years ago, we used to do like the Bhakti Briksha group was little bit prominent in ISB, which Gandharvika Mataji was kind of our main leader, and Anand Rupa Prabhu, he was, I don't know, many of you may not know, but those who are little senior devotees may know, Anand Rupa Prabhu, and then some other devotees, myself, 4, 5, and Raghu Prabhu was there, Priyanka Mataji Raghu Prabhu. So that time we did not have how the organization really helps. And as Harivansa Prabhuji mentioned, how the books and the goals are helping. Because in the earlier days when I know, there was no structure, means because there was no MSF, or Vaisesika Prabhu was doing his book distribution on his own. He was not giving his mercy fully to the congregations at the time. So later on, so it was like everybody was on its own stack. Means, so we go and take books, and beginning we just discuss ourselves. We will start with, you know, small books, which is yoga or nectar instruction or something, because you did not have the courage at the time, not necessarily courage, maybe Krishna has not manifested his potency. So we cannot even, we take 2 or 3 Bhagavad Gita maximum for a sample. We don't basically take it and distribute in the earlier days. But we start with, the goal was we start with the small books, because that was our thought and intention, that we distribute small books. And the only places we go is like Bharat Bazaar and New India Bazaar and 2-3 places where Jananivas Prabhu was there also. We do some Harinam. And the goal was, because it was, the goal was never mentioned how many goals you have to do, how many Gitas you have to do. And it started like that. But nevertheless, anything somebody is writing, that is also the beginning stage, where all the things Krishna saw the sincerity of the devotees in the due course of time. And if you remember, in the earlier days, we never used to distribute Srimad Bhagavatam in first couple of 1 or 2 years, maybe very less. But there was no such power. And that is, even if you design that power, it doesn't come. It comes with certain level of somebody's purification. As Malini Mataji read, that Narad Muni saw Krishna, but he said that you cannot see me. You need more purification and more, advancement in spiritual knowledge. Then only you can be able to see me. You are qualified. So similarly, the test is when Srila Prabhupada also says that 25-50 Bhagavatam set distributed by some devotee, and he would mention, yes, it is a cumulative accumulations of your piti which has come to this stage, and also definitely the mercy of spiritual master. So we are actually going, this signifies or symbolizes that our, the movement, the book distribution movement and ISB is going in a progressive path, which means that we are going in the right directions where the devotees' cooperation is definitely manifesting in the books, because books itself loves, as long as devotees are satisfied, devotees are pleasing to each other and cooperating to each other, the books comes in hand and goes to other places. So that gives all the things, whatever ISB we have been doing, this is a greatest significant, you know, item, that all these peripheral characteristics or attributes of the devotional path which is manifesting simultaneously. That's all. Hare Krishna.
Sadhu, sadhu. Pass it back.
Hare Krishna, Dhanot Pranam. From this Sankirtan, you know, personally learned a lot, and in fact, I think this is the best Sankirtan I have seen at ISV, and very inspiring, best in terms of the mood, just in terms of number of devotees, and then like, you know, it's not dependent on a handful of people. Now, you know, I see it's becoming a big team. And of course, it was the best in terms of the number of books distributed also. I've been inspired by few devotees over this period and like to just mention my learnings. As I said, this is one of the best because of a very nice infrastructure that we have here. Starting with Haldar Prabhu and devotees like Haldar Prabhu and Mataji, who behind the scene are, you know, I've seen them working from 9 to 5, 9 to maybe 9 to 9 on Saturday and Sunday, making the best use of time so that it's very easy to go out and distribute books. One of the, you know, I think, you know, the best person growth, I would say, sorry if I'm just, I've seen Harivamsha Prabhu practically, you know, taking a lot of responsibility, you know, for achieving goals, we need people who take responsibility, deliver, and that has inspired me and, you know, try to imbibe that in my own self. One of the things I've learned and I'm observing is the corporate team of Shraddha Mataji and Prabhuji. It's manifesting in front of my eyes, you know, the mercy flowing from Guru. If someone just follows and tries to please the Guru Maharaj, I can see, you know, how mercy is flowing. It's as if they have their hands in an electric socket and the electricity direct connected. And, you know, that is very inspiring. I mean, I actually wait for their emails. And the way they are doing it, I only wish if I had some of the qualities of, you know, getting Lakshmi the way Shraddha Mataji and Prabhuji are doing, Motni Gita would not need Lakshmi from outside. So, so that is something for me to learn from them. Another thing which has inspired me has been Kameshwari Mataji. She has been a force and I'm just simply inspired by her sincerity. If I'm not mistaken, she has been going out practically every Sunday or every weekend over at least the last few months, I do not know. But thanks to WhatsApp, she keeps on inspiring me and maybe all of us. So she's a truly a big, you know, inspiration. And not only to me, I think, you know, all the parents of the kids. And that's what is inspiring, that we need a big team if you want to do big and not just from a handful of people. Another thing I've learned from Sukeshwari Mataji, wow, she's just amazing in Srimad Bhagavatam distribution. I personally asked her, how do you do it? And she of course gave a lot of credit to Malini Mataji. But I tried, you know, one of her tricks. I asked one of my relatives, they want Srimad Bhagavatam. I wasn't expecting a yes. But he said, okay, I'll think over, okay, I'll take it. And I haven't yet distributed, that just happened day before yesterday. They want Gujarati Srimad Bhagavatam. Well, I have yet to distribute it. I have yet to complete it. But, I mean, I'm just not inspired and, you know, trying to at least contact people who are in my, you know, contact list would approach it. And it's amazing that it's not that difficult as we think sometimes. So that's something I learned from her. Yeah. And of course, SKP Prabhu and Malini Mataji, leaders who are leading from the front. When you have goals, you know, you need to not just be sentimental but very organized. And one of the best thing a leader is to inspire others to get the best out of it, and that is very nice. Honestly, when I heard about the goals at the beginning of 2014 about the sets, I said, now that's difficult. But it turned out to be so easy. And in fact, maybe because I can't distribute so many sets, I get more inspiration, you know, when I hear about sets being distributed. So it's amazing. One other devotee, you know, who has been inspiring me a lot has been Selva Prabhu. Mm. I mean, it's practically a one-person army, and it's even more difficult when you do not get the type of association that probably other book distributors are getting. Usually other book distributors are in a team, it's a very festive atmosphere, but Selva Prabhu has been an inspiration, going practically single-handed and, keeping the smart box thing. He's amazing. In fact, probably the only devotee who has done Srimad Bhagavatam, who has done Motel Gita, who has done Smart Box, and of course other books. In fact, he yesterday called me up and he said he was passing through a motel in Sunnyvale. He went inside and he got an order for 60 books yesterday evening. Another devotee, Vaisesika Prabhu just mentioned devotees without beyond borders. Another devotee, Vedavit Prabhu, who has been, serving not just ISV but everyone in Motel Gita, beyond goals or beyond doing it for my temple, just for the love of distributing books, just for the, just for the sincerity of it. Finally, as a Ananda Mataji, Shyamalangi Mataji, Manjula Kanta Mataji, again Kameshwari Mataji, Sushil Prabhu, they have been inspiring me for doing so much with the kids. Unfortunately, I've not been able to take my kids to so many book distribution sites, but I see how the kids are progressing with these parents who have been inspiring me, to take the kids out, whether it's door to door or festivals or anything. And of course, a big gratitude to all the donors who have, given up their hard-earned income, especially to projects like Motel Gita, which otherwise cannot run without donations. I mean, it's almost assumed or taken for granted, but almost 50% or maybe even more of the Lakshmi is coming through all the donors. So my deep gratitude, and it's not easy in this today's time and world to do that. And of course, it is good fortune to be here with Vaisesika Prabhu, getting his inspiration. He's like the electricity, lighting all the different bulbs which glows and makes it beautiful. So without his inspiration and guidance, nothing would have been possible. As Bali Maradhan Prabhu said, I was in good fortune to be here since last 10, 11 years. And I've learned book distribution from him. And I've seen how everyone at ISV and North America and maybe at all over the world are benefiting. Thank you, Prabhuji. Thank you, dear devotees. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna.
There have been a lot of realizations in this year's book distribution, but I want to share a couple of them. For me, one of the things which strikes topmost in my mind is how much mercy, right? Mahaprabhu's mercy was flowing. So initially, in the beginning of the year, we had the goal for distributing CC sets. So I still remember asking Malini Mataji, what is the goal? She said, 25 sets. We need to distribute 25 sets of CC for this MSF. Now looking back, the number looks small, but at that time, I was wondering, 25 sets door to door, how are we going to do it? So I was asking, telling Mataji, how are we going to distribute CC sets? She said, I don't know, Prabhu, let's try. So the very first weekend that we were trying to going door to door and distributing CC, we ended up distributing 6 or 7 CC sets. So that's, I literally saw Mahaprabhu's mercy, right, flowing at that point. Because we even distributed sets to South Indian people. And most of the South Indian people don't know about Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So they are hearing about him for the very first time. and they ended up taking sets. So that was really, you know, for me it was a big realization. It's not us who's doing that, right? It's Mahaprabhu's mercy is flowing right there. So I remember coming home the other day evening, and that evening, and Manjula Kanta asking me, how many sets did you distribute? I said, we distributed around 7 sets. She was literally shocked. She asked me, none of you have read Chaitanya Charitamrita. At least she knows I haven't. At least she knows I haven't read it. How did you distribute? I told her, we spent 40 minutes talking about Srimad Bhagavatam. And the end, we said, this is the autobiography of the person who lived that life. Please take it. And that's how we distributed, right? Yeah. Because even I remember discussing Mataji, what points do we say for Chaitanya Charitamrita, right? We don't have. But that literally, you know, I could see Lord's mercy flowing there, right there. So the other biggest realization, I thought of sharing with you one-on-one, but anyhow, I'll share with the group. Somewhere towards the middle end of the marathon, I had a feeling, right, we are kind of pushing too hard. When we are distributing books, you know, the way we are approaching people, and we talked, at least for me, right, personally, I felt, because the goal was very high, I felt, you know, we were, somehow or other, we want to distribute the books, and we are really pushing too hard, which probably, you know, we wouldn't do had the goals had not been that high. So I had this question on this in my mind for some time, actually. So I told this to my wife as well about this point, and she didn't have an answer either. Maybe after 2 weeks and after I discussed with her, this thought came to my mind one day while I was chanting as well. So in the night, and after chanting, I went up the room, and Manjula Kanta was reading a book by Prabhupada called Nectar of Book Distribution, the red color book, you know, which basically is a compilation of questions, you know, a lot of devotees have asked Srila Prabhupada about book distribution and his answers to it. You know, she told me, hey, remember you asked me that question? I got the answer. So one or the other, somebody asked Prabhupada a very similar question, right? Aren't we pushing too hard on book distribution and almost trying to sell books? And you know, Prabhupada's answer was, yes, we are pushing hard, but our goal is to distribute books by hook or crook. He says, that's fine, there's nothing wrong in pushing hard. And he even encouraged spiritual competition between the temples as well. So that to me was, for me, the biggest realization is when you have some genuine questions in your heart, how Krishna answers immediately, right? Some form or other. I felt I got the answer right there. When she told me that, so that was another realization. And and I also feel this year our Sankirtan team has become stronger than ever. Haladurupa Prabhu and Kumar Lila Mataji are back. Ramsundar Prabhu and Kamala Relika Mataji joined us. Hari Vamsha Prabhu has also now got involved with Sankirtan this year, and that made a big difference, yeah. So I think we were able to, because of a lot of devotees, we were able to always, you know, we were able to form multiple teams and go in different locations, and each team doing small amount, you know, it made a big difference at the end of the day. So you have 3 teams, and each team said they distribute 3 sets. At the end of the day, you have around 9 sets. So I think that made a big difference. You know, how much small, you know, each one can do, at the end, you know, the end result is really big. So, I hope the team gets stronger this year as well. I really pray to the Lord.
Thank you for those prayers. Hare Krishna. How many sets altogether? For this year, how many did we actually sell during 2014?
Hare Krishna.
How many sets of Bhagavatams? Three. 328 actually sold during 2014. So almost a set, one set a day. So next, this year we can do two a day. Just think, everyone should, when you sell a set, we should start, take two sets, because one for, you know, somebody else. Okay. Bunches like bananas. We were selling the Bhagavatams are a bunch, but we should sell bunches of Bhagavatams. So.
Hare Krishna Maharaj. Maharaj, I think if you reflect back from last year, the inspiration is the key. We get inspiration from multiple sources, from the books, from Prabhupada. I think one of the biggest link which I think is more important is the role modeling. Because inspiration could come from multiple sources, but once you don't see the people who actually do it and a role model that activity, I think that inspires actually more the person to do more. So, I mean, on the role modeling side, I can't find anybody better than, you know, when I noticed in LA Rath Yatra, I mentioned in my offering this year, but you know, the mood which, you know, the you were absorbed in distributing when everybody was getting ready to come back. I mean, that tells us, you know, I mean, not as a group, but to me, but we are just not even a beginners in this game, because it is very, it tells to me, I'm not talking about others, but I think that is the mood I hope one day, you know, we get, because that is what I think makes you what you are. I think that is very, very the role modeling, and that inspires all of us to come to that level. And I see how on a role modeling side, also on Krishna Parshottam Prabhu, when he went to his marriage and he distributed books. that was kind of, you know, at the time, two years ago, 3 years ago, I felt like, oh, you know, maybe, you know, he just did it because it is possible or whatever reasons. But once you see that it was done by somebody and in that special conditions, then why can't I do it? And that inspired, I mean, I'm not on the marriage, but but this time when I went to India, you know, just it just happened that I went to visit the temple there, and I took a full Bhagavad Gita set to distribute to my relatives. I thought, then he could do it to distance relative, why can't I do it? After distributing a little bit to a known people, it itself is a bigger challenge. But I think it's very satisfying once you see people take it, the Prabhupada's books. I think that satisfaction, especially the one whom you know, I mean, that was very, very satisfying, very, very satisfying. So to me, it's more about how we could, the widespread presence of our, you know, or the congregations, or ISKCON's facility, it really facilitated. If had been there no Chandigarh temple there, I would have not been able to carry the books to go there. And similarly, highlighting on LA temple's presence, when we went to LA Rath Yatra, I mean, we distributed so many books, but it wasn't possible had there was no LA location in the temple. We wouldn't use that facility to pack the books and do all that stuff. So the widespread presence to me is, you know, I think the facilities like ISPs here are connecting with to the right, you know, people, other groups. I think that will really help us add, you know, in our movement. Finally, I just wanted to highlight Selva Prabhu's, you know, single army force. I think it's beyond the even role modeling part. You know, role modeling people do because they have been doing for a living and they know it, right? They have practiced that part. But to me, the how much intensity does he have it? I just wanted to highlight one point. Chat Bhavan actually has a smart box, and they do the renovation. They removed that renovation. They said we can't keep it. We took everything out, so there's no space. He has been, because I know the Chat Bhavan owner, and he has been, I think maybe I remember 5 or 6 times asking me, Prabhu, can you request him? I mean, as if this is what he want. And I try to call him, that person, once, twice, it didn't happen. Prabhu, did you call him? And then I feel like, oh, I try to call that person, I went to visit, I see there's no space. He again kept on, Prabhu, did you call? Why don't you ask him? I mean, 5, 6 times, and this is where Krishna was waiting to test maybe my lethargy. He wanted to push me, and I then went once with my brother there, and then somehow owner was there, and I told him, and he said, no problem, we will put it. And there is no space. There is no space. They have a deities there. He said, I'm going to put in this corner something. But that was what was possible. I know the Salva Prabhu is the constant, the intensity in his mind is, I mean, I don't think even matching is different. It's all about if you get even part of it. It's so inspiring. So, I think the addition of, such more devotees in our congregations with such inspiration, it's something which keeps us going in the next year. And I think Harivamsa Prabhu's new drive this year, it's something really special. It's noticeable to everybody, but I just wanted to appreciate that, because he has been here, but this year he's just like like a hockey stick we use in the business terms, right? The volume starts shooting up like a hockey stick. You're there, but you just took it off. I just wanted to appreciate his the contribution to that one. Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. I myself didn't go for a lot of the book distributions and the marathons, but whenever I did, I felt that it was not me who was going. Like the devotees, somehow they carried me. They're so enthusiastic. The enthusiasm, that's the biggest highlight for me. And even if I'm at home, if I couldn't go or I'm going late, the WhatsApp, it keeps your mind there. Even if I am not physically there, I'm like counting, oh, this team did this much, this, that team did that much. So the enthusiasm is really, that is a thing which, for like some backseated like devotees like me, it's like the biggest highlight. And one more thing which I noticed whenever I went, that there are a lot of good people outside. I mean, I feel even I would not have been that receptive like a few years back, the way I see some families. The first time they hear, they're like, they are convinced, or as if they already have that knowledge inside, but it's just not manifested. So I really like it, and I wish they get closer to Krishna consciousness, because they did receive the books, but I hope Bhagavatam does like miracles to their lives now. That's it.
Excellent. Hansapriya is ready.
Hare Krishna. So I'm not the part of the book distribution, but I'm like a person who stands on the, all the way far on the seesaw and wait for the wave to come and drag you in. So I get a little bit of, water here and there, or the mercy of yours. And I go, and I wanted to mention that I more play the role of observant, and I just get sometimes overwhelmed thinking about it, that how beautifully you go out. There are difficulties that you put up to just go out every weekend. There is things to do at home, things to do at work. There is always constantly the waves. That's, you can have 100,000 reasons to stay back, but you just focus. You're just cruising. You're just like... Kesho Bharti Maharaj says, keep trucking. And I see that when I see you guys, that yes, you keep trucking, and that's what I need to follow. I also felt that when I went out with Krishna Purushottam Prabhu to see this motel owner, that we know him from long distance, from almost 10, 12 years. And he knows also one of the devotees in the congregation who is close to that motel owner, and try to convince him to take the Gita. Apparently, he did not end up taking it for one or other reason. And then I went through another channel, which is Kal Mehta, and I asked him if he can put me in touch with him. And due to the Kal's word, the person agreed to meet with us, and he took some Gita. And he pulls into his $60,000 car, Tesla, and you know, just gets there because we had this appointment. He gets there, and we walking with the Bhagavad Gita. He opens the door for a Bhagavad Gita to come in. And he himself didn't have his assistant on that day, so he tries to figure it out how to give us a check. So he gives us a printed check. He puts his hand on the Gita half of the time and is trying to figure things out. So I see that I'm just observing things, and I was thinking, do you know what, maybe does he get mercy by even just putting his hand, because I don't know when he will read it. But his hand, and then I'm just watching, and when we were leaving, we were telling him about the smart boxes and, you know, the other programs that we have. And the guy, he says, let me know if I can help you with anything else. I have different projects that I can help. And I was thinking, this guy, we've been trying from 12 years to, you know, even just come around the temple. But I was thinking, not to just, you know, he had in his heart that he want to help out. But it sometimes matters if the pure devotee comes around. And I was happy to bring Krishna Purushottam because of his purity. And I felt that where he says, Lau Matra Sadhu Sangha, how it can be impacted right immediately. So I was just thinking, Bhagavad Gita, the Srila Prabhupada's labor of love and a presence of a devotee can do such a miraculous thing that the guy, he has a $60,000 car, multi-million businesses, but he wants to do something good that makes a difference in his own personal life. So until you do the ultimate, you know, well-wishing for others, you cannot help others. So I was thinking he wanted to help out, and I was thinking how Srila Prabhupada's book distribution is allowing people to get engaged, those who are not even qualified, or those who one doesn't know that, you know, they have a possibility to be delivered. And many other incidents that I see here, that how each and every individual contributes. And I remember the story that about, I don't know exactly how it goes, but only I remember the part that when devotee is thinking that, you know, Krishna is going to pass elephant through the eye of a needle. So when I see all of you and I see the path of devotional service is how much you are all advanced, and I cannot just figure it out how it connects, but with the mercy of Krishna, I can see that, you know, that Krishna is actually right here, you know, passing all these things through the eye of a needle. So Hare Krishna.
I'd like to acknowledge all the devotees who have joined us on the internet from many different places. There's also five devotees on the phone, and we'll take this opportunity to hear one of the comments from someone who's texted in from the internet. And we encourage all of you to either call in or text in. The lines are always open here. This is a universal community for hearing and chanting, so please feel part of the group. Shraddha will read a text that just came in.
Thank you, Maharaj. Before I read that, I just wanted to comment on Hansa Priya Mataji's. We were talking about bhaktas beyond the borders, and she actually crosses the species borders.
You better unpack that.
So most of us talk about human beings beyond country borders and that kind of stuff, or temple borders. But Hansi Premanathji actually engages her dog, Snicker, in book distribution.
And he did a lot this year.
He did.
I think he was way beyond the 10% increase, that's for sure.
Yeah. So this message is from Bhaktin Kathleen. Kathleen, and she says, she offers her humble obeisances to you, Maharaj. And she says that my greatest realization last year was it was time to seek shelter from a bona fide spiritual master. And then, of course, she goes and takes shelter from one who is an ace book distributor. And she says that Krishna has arranged for me to distribute books at work so that those recovering from drug and alcohol addiction can come to know Krishna.
Arriba. Yeah, you have to find your higher power, and when you do, you have to really know what that means. And when you do know what your higher power is and how to take shelter, then you can actually really take shelter. And otherwise, if you're not convinced, if you don't know the characteristics of the higher power, what it means that there's a higher power and so forth, then you may lose traction. Haladhar Rupa.
Yeah, Hare Krishna Rupa. Prabhu, my realization, it's not only just 2014, but over the period of years, like 2 to 3 years, I see like how the, you know, Sankirtan is, becoming a driving force behind everything I do in my Krishna consciousness. Like do the chanting, every time my chanting is, not perfect, then, I see the devotees in association when I go to Sankirtan, how they are doing their chanting. They have finished their chanting early in the morning. And they are reading Prabhupada's books. They are doing they are taking care of the deities at their homes. So everything I'm learning when I'm going for the Sankirtan, and it's becoming, everything Sankirtan for me, everything I'm learning from there. And as, Malini Mataji mentioned that, every weekend from the ISU we are going, and that is becoming, kind of routine is very nice to in my life, like as you mentioned one time in saying that Jayadwada Swami mentioned that he do each and every things, every day. And this is like every Saturday just book for Sankirtan. And like in my office, like as Friday comes, people ask, what is your weekend plan? What is your weekend plan? Every single Friday they ask, they have nothing to ask. So, I said there is no plan, but I have my other plans. So, it's become routine is making my life simple and, giving me time to think about what I'm doing. And what world, the cooperation, it says, in marathon last year went really well. Like, we can see the success of, big festivals like Go Green Festival, Pumpkin Festival, as well as the, Bhagavatam says, Warm Spring community was really good. Like, we knock the door each and every, and out of that, how many number of doors open, there is a 40% chance we give them Bhagavatam set. So it was a really huge, a big success. So I think we thanks to Sukheswari Mataji to find out that community for us. And Sankirtan is also giving the lifetime memory, like how you, have the good time with devotees, how you share some points which is really, touch to their hearts. And, I prepared the slides, right? And by seeing the pictures of 2014 Sankirtan, it's giving the, joy inside, how those days was when we are convincing this family, and in the starting he was not convinced and he ended up taking the Bhagavatam set. So, and regarding the, Sankirtan, is kind of also, spiritual competition, and especially due to this WhatsApp group, like sometimes we go, in different groups, and some groups already did, starting selling up the Bhagavatam sets, and that giving us encouragement or kind of anxiety, saying that, hey, we have to do that. There is no prasadam time or there is no break, just first, let's finish our goal. So that's how we are achieving the goals. And also this year Union Square was also a very good spot. I found there are so many nice realizations, like people over there. Some people, like, they are, one person I came across, he's very old, and I think he's from Asia, somewhere China, and he just walked by to me, and he said, like, what are you giving out? I said, books. Then I said, this is the books, Bhagavad Gita, I explained to him. And I thought he will not give any Lakshmi. And I asked him, you know, do you want to give any donation? He didn't reply anything. And then after that, he and his wife both were just staying that. And he was, you know, slowly, he was showing his ID. And then he, you know, take out his wallet and then give it out $1. And he said, like, I'm poor, but I know the value of this knowledge, so I'll give you the donation. And he gave $1. So that, you know, touching the hearts, and it's kind of lifetime lesson. This lesson doesn't, you know, teach any of the universities or any of the corporate world. And this is, you know, giving the good value in myself as, you know, going to Sankirtan. And also, you know, like, it's like, in San Francisco, you know, especially in January 4th, we went, it was so cold. It was too cold there. And I mean, like, I had like 3 or 4 layers of, you know, like jackets, but still it was too cold, and shoes got, you know, really cold. Then hard to stay after 5 p.m. And I see, even, you know, like, the happiness or kind of anxiety over there was really far better than I went, you know, a couple of weeks before in Hawaii and went 10,000 up for seeing the sunrise. So there is nothing comparison I can do that. So it's gives Prabhu, you know, like, nice lessons and cooperation, and everyone is doing, so I'm doing. That is also, you know, getting the mood into it. And pulling and giving, you know, like, asking other people, it will be easy if everyone is going there. So it's only a couple of devotees are going, then it will be hard others to join. That is also, I learned that, Prabhu. That's all. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Hare Rama. The Prophet recognized that there was a spirit of competition amongst the devotees, and one particular letter that he wrote to he wrote a similar letter with a similar phrase. Some devotees who were expressing desire to become more involved in Sankirtan and saying that they were going to do really well in book distribution. And at that time, the San Francisco temple was #1. And Prabhupada would end the letter in saying, yes, it's very nice if you, you know, become the best in Sankirtan, then I'll have to come and stay there. But then he'd say, but I do not think that anyone can catch up with San Francisco. He was like, and he said that several times to other people. It's like, why? You know?
Prabhu, the point Haradharupa mentioned about the spiritual competition, right? So I could witness it within our group itself. So I think one weekend, one group went to San Ramon, one group went to Cupertino, and one group went to some other place. So thanks to the WhatsApp, right? We have this live broadcast. Whenever we distribute a set, we immediately post a picture and said, so I still remember SKP Prabhu telling me, Prabhu, San Ramon team has distributed one. Let's come on, let's go. I could feel him feeling that anxiety. Let's come on, we have to catch them.
Actually, we were saying the same thing.
But at the end of the day, right, when we eventually caught up, SKP Prabhu came and told me, Prabhu, come on, we did it. But it was a nice feeling at the end of the day, but even though you feel that anxiety in the middle, but...
Yeah, WhatsApp was a big breakthrough this year, wasn't it? Yeah, I noticed that wherever I was, all day long, ding, 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 and I was like, people were going, why is your phone dinging so much? I said, every time it goes, there's a book was sold, you know? So it's a nice feeling. It's very good. Yes.
Thank you, Maharaj. It's so enlightening to just hear the experience. Maybe I'll just share some small thing what I learned. As you tell that when we learn Shastra, we are in the front seat, like we go to see movie, like you're in the front seat seeing the same thing. Similarly, when being in Sankirtan with one of the most enthusiastic devotee, I feel that I'm in the front seat and seeing in myself everything what's happening. So I think I should say first I will say especially about Shraddha Mataji, like how she did this, but it was not just just externally, but it was internally. It comes from the heart that she really want to meet people, distribute them and connect them with Prabhupada. And it's all, it starts with what you taught so nicely over the year, how properly organize, how six times give and one time take, and always be in the giving mode, not just taking mode. And that makes a difference. It's not, most time we just want to take, but there is a giving part as well. And that if we focus on more giving part, Krishna automatically makes sure that he takes 10 times more than what we give. So it's it's also the heart, what is there in the heart. Sometimes we hear that, okay, there are a lot of external difficulties, this, that, and I know personally, like last 3 months he's suffering from frozen shoulder and so many other diseases, but every weekend, want to go, whatever happen, is actually driving that force to, okay. And not only just weekend, it's weekdays, that is another thing, that to contemplate every day when wake up, okay, whom to meet. And those who do in the corporate, they can understand it's not easy thing, it's the most difficultest thing, because yourself has work. And being in a more responsible position, it's not easy to just go out. And after going out also is really different experience. you meet, like one time she was sharing that she asked some of the very senior person, okay, you like to take book? And he told no. Then he said, I don't have any answer what to say next. It's such a high person saying. So it's a really... inspiring to be in that and seeing the front row, all this thing happening every day. I'm waiting for my text, okay, this many books done, this text, and so. And and also I'd like to share in the same line the realizations that I had. We met maybe, I think last MSF, one person in the temple, and he just casually met Shraddha Mataji, and Mataji gifted her a book. And then he happened to be my colleague in my office, and she connected, okay, that person to me. It was 2 years before, and then I followed up with him, and the first time he told, and he, I asked him, okay, how you like the book and other things. He was like furious, like anything. How can be supreme, you can tell Krishna is supreme personality of Godhead, like how can, why should we believe him? So many things, and it happens. But okay, it goes on, and then last year, then this year, I used to follow up with him, something, give calendar, or like give prasadam, invite temple, used to do okay. Then this year, it so happened that somehow Krishna inspired him to again, like, but I can see that changes happen during the time. The first time when he was there, he was so much infuriated just to, okay, why I should believe Krishna is saying, and why I should believe that kind of mentality. And then he started submissively hearing what is there and asking questions about Bhagavad Gita. And then recently, in his home, someone visited his friend and they saw that Bhagavad Gita which Mataji given him. And he told, okay, we want to take this Bhagavad Gita. So he told, okay, take it. So that, as you told, that sometime even person we give book, it may not be meant for him, it may mean for someone, and I see that clearly it went to someone else. But then he came next day and asked, okay, I want my Bhagavad Gita. So he given me no money, and he told, okay, this $20 take and give me a Bhagavad Gita for myself. I can see that attachment developed for Bhagavad Gita. And then after some day, actually he was going on some outing, and then he met someone he did from, so he used to always then started carrying Bhagavad Gita with him. So he was going in some outing and he carried Bhagavad Gita in his trunk, and someone hit him from the trunk. And it was like, it was very serious accident, and he told that the whole Bhagavad Gita also and got in that accident gone. I told, yeah, see, Krishna has saved you just by being in Bhagavad Gita there. And then he again asked me, okay, give me one more Bhagavad Gita because I lost. And he was like, as soon as accident happened, he told me, I want to an next Bhagavad Gita because I lost my Bhagavad Gita. So I see that over of the period how he developed from the attitude of just like even not wanted to hear to having so much respect and love towards Bhagavad Gita. So that was the name. So.
I just wanted to add one thing. I just want to take 1 minute. when I used to work in India back, there is for a Japanese multinational company. When I used to present my product to the customer, I had a very strong conviction that my quality is the best. I mean, it's true because Japanese quality has been, you know, comparing with other multinationals at the time, with best of my knowledge, I had a very strong conviction. I was just trying to correlate when I was hearing the conversation in the last minute. That strong conviction in ourselves and the purity of Prabhupada's message is there. So there's nothing, I mean, actually for us to do it. Because once you have that strong conviction, things you can sell it. Because on your face you can't fake for longer time. You know, you could be, you know, advertised for a few days like this, but when you have to talk for long and long time, the conviction in ourselves is the selling force, which actually sells in my mind, I was just thinking. And I think Prabhupada has already gave us everything, you know, and our conviction will sell the books. So I just thought to share that it's the... As we go out, the belief in the literature that this is the best. And once, when I went to India, when I was speaking to my relatives, trying to talk, that the same feeling when I used to sell my product in India, I had in my mind that there's no competition here. I mean, just taking a corporate, comparing it in the corporate world, but this is not a one-to-one comparison, but still with that conviction, it becomes so easy. People could see your body language. They could feel you with such conviction you speak. Rest Krishna does his magic, of course. You know.
Yeah, as I was talking about earlier about how purity is the force. And that's a symptom of purity, that the mind is cleared of other competing ideas about what might be a good idea to do in life. In other words, if someone has this conviction that if you just chant Hare Krishna and read Srimad Bhagavatam, then everything good will come. And if you do anything other than that, then nothing good will come. This is a purity of understanding that. And Prabhupada had that purity when he came to America. And he mentioned also, and he talks about this in the Chaitanya Charitamrita in a purport, that other members of the Gaudiya Mat had been sent to the West. But he says, because in their heart, they actually didn't have that conviction. They really were not prepared within the heart to spread Krishna consciousness all over the world. They had some other doubts about it. I don't want to go into the details about what the doubts were, because it would be speculation. But he said they didn't have that firm conviction. They had some other idea. And therefore, they weren't successful. They had to come back. And they claimed some success when they came back, and of course, just going is successful. But they were called back by their spiritual master, who saw that they were becoming more affected than the population, and so forth. So really, the ingredient that Prabhupada talks about over and over again is the conviction within one's heart that there is nothing better than this. That's unstoppable in presenting a conclusion or a particular a product, especially when it's well-reasoned, it's not fanatical, it's realized knowledge. When it becomes solidified in one's life through maturity, through experience, and one sees that this is the only panacea, that it's easy to be tolerant and present to people over and over again, even when they say no, and not be affected by it, by them saying, oh no, I have something else, because we're not interested in something else. Thank you. That was a very practical point. Yes, Prekishori.
Hare Krishna. So this 2014 was definitely a great increase, 10% increase in book distribution, especially we could see it firing in ISV. And I was meditating on how this consciousness of, and this conviction, as you were saying, Prabhu, was the was very prevalent in the hearts of the Vaishnavas. And their real main occupation was not software engineer, teacher, student, whatever, and their real main occupation was to go out and give these books to everybody and basically push the hands into the books of people using their skills, their occupation, whatever they had to distribute these books. And I could practically see that when every 5 minutes my phone would say, oh, you know, my coworker gets a Bhagavad Gita, and Sukeshwari Mataji especially, my friend, you know, Bhagavad Gita, and so many interesting things. That I especially remember the kids giving Bhagavad Gita to their teachers. And when we were in San Francisco and we were coming out and backing up, we were in the parking lot, and there was a car coming from the back, and it was a Benz car, and my mother was also backing up, and she hit us, and I was immediately shocked. You know, how much are we going to have to pay for this? It's a Benz car. And then the lady comes out, and she's so nice. She says, you know, I'm sorry, this is my problem, I'll fix it, we'll pay for it, everything. And I was really taken aback by what a person she was. And then Sukeshwari Mataji comes out with a Bhagavad Gita and hands it to her. And we figured out that her name is Shefali Razdan, and she is one of something like Tulsi Gabbard. And she was going to take an oath on Bhagavad Gita, and she was going to use the book we gave her to do so. So it was so nice that...
So the accident was Krishna's arrangement. Where am I going to get a Gita?
So we were going back and forth about insurance and everything, and then she sent us an email and said, thank you so much for the Bhagavad Gita. So I was seeing that how devotees like Sukeshwari Mataji, all of the devotees here, they use every opportunity to present Bhagavad Gita to them, to the masses. And and Srimad Bhagavatam was especially big this MSF, and definitely Indian apartments and friends and acquaintances were a great facility for distributing Srimad Bhagavatams. But one of the well-strategized leaps of this MSF was stepping into other different grounds, like San Francisco, Haight-Ashbury, Union Square, Market and Powell. And I could it was just a new step to talk to Westerners. And we saw people coming from this, like really old people coming from the 70s saying, you're the Hare Krishnas, right? And say, I got a book, this and then, and I went to so-and-so temple, and it's so nice that you guys are back on the streets, you know, distributing Bhagavad Gitas. And not only those, but I felt like I was connected to the past. And it's not only those people, we found people who are saying, I've been looking for this for such a long time, and people in tears. And one lady, she was on the run, you know, all her stuff was in a little cart, and I guess she would sleep on the street every day. And I gave her a Bhagavad Gita, and she said, she gave me a big hug, and with tears in her eyes, she said, thank you so much, I've been looking for this for 40 years. Mm. So that was such a... it shows that, you know, now it's become quite stylish and quite the modern fashion to go out and do community service. You know, so-and-so corporation goes out to some neighborhood and plants a tree and calls it the day and says that, you know, we did a lot of community service. But what's happening now is that devotees are who have this conviction are going out to every place in the Bay Area, which is ignorantly conceived of as having everything. They go and plant these kalpavriksha trees of the books, which actually give what is the only thing that's needed, which is true contentment and knowledge of the Supreme Personality of Godhead and knowledge of your relationship with Him. And these kalpavriksha trees are like little grabbers. They reclaim the souls, as Srila Prabhupada says. And also the goals, when I would come and see the banner that was newly printed, I would think, oh my gosh, how are we ever going to reach that goal? But when you see when there's pressure, when there's a lot of stress, you know, the coal is pressed and pressed and you get this wonderful diamond. And also when there's a really nice flower and you squeeze it out, the true colors and the true smell comes out. So these goals were exactly like that. They really pressed out the true qualities of wonderfulness in every single devotee, and we could see it pop out and make this beautiful garland that we offered to Srila Prabhupada last weekend, which is very nice. And I always love to read this quote, which is from Srila Prabhupada, which I think was written to Rameshwar Prabhu, and it says, "Whatever progress we have made, it is simply due to distributing these books. So go on and do not divert your mind for a moment from this." This was maybe not said, but practically walked by every single devotee, going from, you can see in the pictures, Krishna Priya, you know, all the way to our Sankirtan leaders. And I'm really grateful to be in a small part and at least witness what miracles are taking place on 1965 Latham Street.
When you mentioned the poster, I was thinking it's also metaphorical of how our poster for Sankirtan has grown over the years. And how when we started, we had a small poster, and now it's become large. And I remember the discussion we had about having a large poster and how much it costs to have a poster and so forth. And then realizing in our conversation that one of the reasons we make it large and prominent and we put a lot of money into the poster is because then we do feel that this is a big thing. We better make the poster worthwhile. It can't be a small event. It's actually a big thing. And it is indicative, though, when I'm looking at this, remember the small ones that used to come in and we'd have them on the wall, and this has grown over the years also, step by step through strategy, planning, part of the strategy, and Krishna's mercy, the devotee's sincerity. Sukeshwari. And then one day we'll have the whole wall.
Hare Krishna Prabhu. This year has actually been a very, very, very detailed lot of realizations. And I just thought in my mind that I always heard book distribution is so important. And just like that, I just felt that I wanted to follow in the footsteps of SKP Prabhu and Malini Mataji, and asked Malini that what should I do? I just wanted to go try it out. So she gave me a couple tips, and truly, till today, I'm trying my best. So whatever I have done is because of the tips that I got from Malini, and of course from Vaisesika Prabhu. I was thinking that, you know, Prabhu always says that carry books, you know, and, you know, you need to just present, because it just goes, because it's Srimad Bhagavatam and Bhagavad Gita, so I basically don't do anything. It's already there. I just wanted to share one small thing. Yesterday, I was just listening to this conversation that Srila Prabhupada had, a room conversation, and Kirtida Mataji from Florida was sharing with me. She said that all the devotees were asking Prabhupada that, you know, we want some tips on book distribution. We want to be able to do well. Everybody was sitting and very raptly listening, that they were wondering what would Prabhupada say. The first thing that he said is, the only thing that he said is, you have to sit and chant your 16 rounds in one sitting. And it was a shock to me, because for the past couple months, I actually read the Shravanadi Jal that Prabhu had sent in. And I was thinking that every time I have to go for book distribution today, I have to make sure that I get up early and finish my 16 rounds in one sitting and only take the books out. And that's what I've been trying to do. And I just thought that Prabhuji had sent it in Shravanadi Jal. And then later, after a couple months, I hear from Mataji that this is the same answer that Srila Prabhupada told the devotees, where everybody was expecting that Prabhupada is going to say, you know, maybe do this for book distribution, maybe do that, but it was chanting. Another part that I always thought about is book distribution is important, but I have to also do other services. And I was that's what I was thinking all these years. But I read so many quotes, but one quote that really stuck me, and I know about the time, so I'm just going to keep myself just to a couple things that Prabhupada says. He says that book distribution is the best way to collect money. So it says, we can send you unlimited number of books. This is a letter written to Gopal Krishna Maharaj, Los Angeles, 21st June 1975. He says, we can send you unlimited number of books. You simply have to apply your brain how to sell them. Then you will have plenty of money. This is my mission. You know, started when I came alone to your country by selling my books. And still, whatever money we are getting, it is coming from the book selling. So it's already proven how important the book selling is. So I always thought that how do we get Lakshmi Mary to do this project, maybe to do that project, maybe we have to do this little bit more, maybe we can get Lakshmi. But then he made it so clear, and he also says one more which he wrote to Tamakrishna Maharaj in 1969. He says, if you can arrange for selling of those books, there will be no scarcity of money, either for the father or for the son. So yeah, I just wanted to share that. It's just been beautiful, and thank you all. You know, for me, I realized that book distribution is so much important compared to everything else that I've been doing. Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Sundar.
Ramananda sir.
Yes.
Whenever someone wants to go out and book distribution, chant 16 rounds in one sitting, that is not whenever one wants to go on book distribution, that is every day.
But one thing is that this is one of the reasons we talk about why book distribution is such a powerful service. You may not realize that you need to every day, but when you combine book distribution, which is powerful, and hearing and chanting with value, you get a super powerful combination. Just like rice is a good food, beans are a good food, but when you mix them together, there's a synergy that makes a superfood. And there's this impetus when you're going out, you know that you have to be more ready than ever before to deal with people's subtle bodies in different ways. And you bring up your chanting. But Ramananda Sakya Prabhu makes a nice point. Yes, every day.
Yes. Yes, Prabhu. Yeah, that's so true. And, you know, trying our best with the situation that I'm in. And I just wanted to add, Srivatsa had shared two things that he wanted. He very unlikely, he's very shy, he doesn't want to talk. But he asked me, he was just thinking that every time we go on book distribution with kids on to Indian communities, and he's been asking me, we should go to Saratoga, we should go to non-Indian communities. We're looking at everybody as a soul, so we need to start looking at, you know, yeah, for the goal.
This year we're going to have a quota system, affirmative action to make sure that, which will include, I think, some festivals where everyone will learn a language. We should have a language, special featured language of the month. And all the kids can learn a new language. And all the adults, everybody, can learn a new language each month. So we'll pick out 12 languages. What's that?
WhatsApp banned for that language. All the communication in WhatsApp with that language.
Have a WhatsApp? You can only communicate in WhatsApp today. Not so extensive, but actually, there's ways in which to a little bit of communication each language, knowing the culture and so forth, makes it so that you can enter into that culture. It's very, very little is needed, but some consciousness and awareness. And I like that the kids are pushing for this. It's very good. Sundar, you had a point?
I was trying to say that we should go to non-Indian communities because I know we're great book distributors and all, but it's just that I think most of our books go away because we're distributing them to Indians. So if we go to non-Indian communities, Indians still will become Krishna conscious because they'll just hear, oh, there's a Krishna temple here, let's go there. And then they'll come and they can become Krishna conscious. Well, in non-Indian communities, if you tell them that there's a Krishna temple, they have no idea who Krishna is in the first place. So if we go there and explain to them about the Bhagavad Gita, it's kind of like a chain effect. We tell one person about it, they'll go like, hey, you know, someone gave me a Bhagavad Gita today. And then it's going to spread like wildfire. Wow. So
Sukeshri, can I borrow him as a national spokesperson? He may not even know that, but this is actually one of the hottest topics in America and in the world. And I distributed that lecture by Devamrita Swami. And we have our own Sri Kumar Prabhu, who's promoting this Western preaching and so forth. But I think this is something that will come up in our next session, just after prasadam, which will be at 10 o'clock, in the brainstorming, talking about what I like to call bhakti habitat, developing a habitat, a home where people from various cultures will feel satisfied and they're taken care of, and then reaching out to them. And that's a very important point. So we may have you speak more about that during the year. So be ready, okay? Keep preparing.
So, Sukhetan Mataji, you can have 2 years.
At least some. We should break through to that section for Bhagavatam sales, because it'll have an effect everywhere when we learn how to reach out and actually place a full sets of Bhagavatams in the homes of various kinds of people. Okay, Sundarananda Prabhu. So we're counting down. Prasadam is at 10 o'clock. We had Guru Puja earlier this morning. Today is a day about reflecting, talking, and then brainstorming, which will come up at 10:30. So please go ahead, Sundar.
One realization I had is that, Prabhu, you know, while distributing in 2014, is that we have heard this verse, Tana Pi Suni Chena, Tarora Pi Sahishuna, Manina Manadena Kirtaniya Sadahari. At least I have heard it so many times. But I felt that book distribution is one service where this can be easily applied. And when you are actually going on to book distribution, automatically you have to be, basically in a position of a beggar, and that puts you in a humble state of mind, and people can say anything they want, and you have to be tolerant, and you have to give them respect no matter what, whether they don't regard your plea or don't take any book. So, and also the reason why I think all the acharyas and Srila Prabhupada and you yourself emphasize this service so much is because I guess without applying this principle, there is I think this principle is so essential for progress in our devotional service. And I also felt that we give books to others and we reach out to so many people and they get benefited, and we of course expand our movement also by bringing in contact, by coming in touch with so many people, and so that is the movement also expands, and that is also benefit. But I think the biggest benefit is we ourselves doing that activity actually, and getting the mercy of the Supreme Lord through the parampara and from you actually. And other than that, you know, some light points, like I was happy that a lot of book distribution was done in Fremont and and it was convenient for me to because of the multiple locations we were doing, it was convenient to go. And in spite of the, you know, busy schedule and so many things happening in life, but the Sankirtan at SFO was very special. The yearly Thanksgiving Sankirtan that we did, Harinam Sankirtan we did in SFO, was very, very special actually. And I think that's, and I think that my biggest motivation is that it pleases, all the Acharya Srila Prabhupada, it pleases you and it pleases the devotees. So that's my biggest motivating factor.
Avantika.
Hare Krishna. So whenever we go book distribution, we always see that all the devotees are always in a team and they're always really enthusiastic. And whenever they distribute Srimad Bhagavatam, they go in like transcendental ecstasy, and then they get their phones out and then they start WhatsApping it. And then they're really satisfied. And I think that lots of other devotees were saying, we should go to also non-Indian communities, and we should give like different language books and things like that. And Lastly, I wanted to say, this is a Prabhupada quote. He said, book distribution is our real business. If we give them something else, such as a record player, only their senses will be gratified. However, if we give them books, they will be eternally benefited. So I really like that quote.
Shishirada Madan Mohanji Ki Jai. I'm seeing a pattern here amongst the kids. And on one side, in kind of a lighthearted way, it's you know, charming. And on another side, it's very serious realization that they're having about expanding to other audiences. You know, from the mouth of babes, this is coming, this kind of realization. You have a point before I go on.
Oh, yeah. Hare Krishna. So I think this year was my favorite year of book distribution, all in all. I liked the book distribution was really fun going, because like there was very nice association, like all the kids were very friendly, and it was very easy to book distribute with all of them. Like they wouldn't hog the show when you book distributed, and that really helped a lot. I also liked that the kids were going to festivals, because I think that helped a lot, and it was more fun when we went to festivals. So like we went like out to different places. I think the seminar you gave on Bhagavad Gita really helped us. But I also think the kids should learn to distribute different types of books, because right now most of them are really centered on Bhagavad Gita. Like I know I think Bhagavad Gita's, like I'm mostly doing Bhagavad Gita's right now, but I think we should learn to distribute other books, like, I don't know, Nectar of Devotion or that small. Yeah, like Krishna book, no, but like the other one, The Journey Home. No, not Journey Home. Wait, sorry, something. Self-discovery. Yeah, I also think that the kids should get a higher percentage of like our goals. like 20% or 15% or something, because I think our goals right now are really easy, and we should challenge ourselves more. So if you give us like 15% of the monthly thing, it would help. 15.
50.
50. 50. I mean, 5-0 is okay too.
So as I was saying, this sort of reinforced it. I really like hearing from the kids, because they're not really kids anymore. They're actually young, you know, turning into young adults. They're heading in that direction. And I can see that they're developing their own impetus and realization. And I'm also foreseeing that how they are going to take over the leadership, because they have their own determination. And because, you know, they're growing up in this environment, many of them are growing up at ISV from pillar to post. And I think, and I've seen in other communities where kids are given a stake. They're given part of the goal, they're given a leadership roles and things like that, that they actually take it up. And when they start getting into their teens and then their 20s and things like that, they become proficient to actually take over the organization and lead it in certain aspects. And that's one of the best things that could possibly happen. So I like these ideas that are coming out, realizations that their kids are having and their own determination to do more and so forth. And one thing is that we have to have, we just have to have a little chanting before the prasadam, because every program has to be preceded by and finished by chanting. You had one last point, and then we'll chant.
Yes, Hare Krishna. So, one word description, if I have to say, about my realization of 2014 association of the Sankirtan book distribution movement is, I felt like it's Ram Rajya. So people who are associated with that term know that that feeling of contentment or a fulfilling experience of being in a natural habitat. So given the performance and solid strategy under your able guidance, I think the best is yet to be witnessed.
Yeah, you look very happy. Every time I see you, and you're always there, and you've joined in. And this is one of the wonderful experiences of having these Sankirtan parties. As you see, new devotees come in to the environment, and then they naturally become enlivened and take up their own impetus. And I've seen that in you. You've come in and you've had this desire to be part of it and are feeling the happiness of doing the yajna. So we all pray to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu that he may protect and empower you so that you can continue your service and do wonderful things for the Sankirtan movement. Thank you very much.
Hare Krishna.
Namo Vishnupadaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Sri Mate Bhaktivedanta Swami Niti Namine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavari Paschata Deshatarine Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Sri Advaita Radhara Shivasari Gora Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Nitai Gaur Premanande. Sharirad Vijaja Jodendriya Tahika Jive Pele Vishayasha Gore Dharma de jivayati Lobam vesu durmati Take jeta katita shansare Krishna bora doyamoy Koribare jihajar Shaprasad anadilo baha Shayanam rita pao Radha Krishna gunaga Premedako Shri Chaitanya Nita Premedako Shri Chaitanya Nita Mabrashari Govinde Nam Brahmani Vaishnave Swapa Punya Vatam Rajan Vishraso Navijai Prasade Sarvatukanam Hani Rasyo Pajayate Prasana Cheta Soyashu Bhuri Parya Vatishtate Bhagavad Sri Mahaprasade Ki Gopremanande Nitai Gaura Hari Bo Hari Bo Hari Bo Nitai Gaura Hari Bo I'd like to thank the cooks for the today. I don't see Avantika. Nilisha Mataji, Hansapriyata Mataji, anyone else who did the shopping, all those who donated for the boga, to the fire god for giving us the heat. Thank you very much to everyone involved. Nitai Gaur Haribo, 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 Nitai Gaur Haribo. Please come take prasadam, Hare Krishna. And we have one last message here. This come in from our online audience.
This is coming all the way from Canada. Shyam Mohini and Radha Mohan Prabhu.
Wow.
They say they feel privileged to hear and see all the glorious Sankirtan devotees. All glories to the team, ISV.
We feel privileged to have Shyam Mohini and Radha Mohan on the line listening. They're the masterminds behind the Toronto Sankirtan, which has had a precipitous rise over the last few years under their management and the management of the other devotees at the temple there, who are all working together very cooperatively and every year increasing book distribution. Let's give them a hand. They had a miracle ending to their marathon. They were quite a few sets away from reaching their goals. Lakshmi was far away. I had visited there and I was wondering, how will this happen? And then they let me know just at the end of the month that miracles had happened, and they had rallied at the end, and they surpassed their goals. So congratulations to everybody in Team Toronto. Hare Krishna. So, take prasadam. Everyone sit on that side of the room. Put away all the mats. And then we'll come back. Actually, you can leave most of them out, and everyone can sit on that side of the room. And then we'll come back here around 10:35, and we're going to start a brainstorming session to pick up all the best practices and ideas for improving in the new year. Thank you, Hare Krishna. Jai! Gaura Bhaktivinoda ki! Jai! Srila Prabhupada ki!